Hello everyone, with the video of this week I would like to show you how to perform an analysis of backlink and post-backlink. For that purpose we have created this document where we show you how to do the analysis for a square composite flat plate. I recommend you to go through the document very carefully because we explain you everything you need to know: the geometrical parameters for the composite plate, the boundary conditions you need to define, and also the material properties. We explain step by step what you need to do for the linear eigenvalue analysis and the post-backlink analysis. But with this video I would like to show you all these steps in the graphical user interface of Abacus, so let's get started. I have created two models, one for each analysis, for the linear eigenvalue and for the post-backlink. Basically, they have the same part and material definition, but they are a little bit different in the step, load, and boundary condition. I will show you this difference right now. First, I'm going to start with the linear eigenvalue analysis. For that, as always, you need to create your part, which is a 3D deformable shell, and you need to define the dimensions in the sketch, which are 100 by 100 millimeters. You click done, and then you can go to the material creation, which is a little bit different this time because we are creating a composite. For that, you select mechanical, elasticity, elastic. So this is the same than always, but this time instead of taking isotropic you should select lamina, and here you define the values for the mechanical properties we give to you in the document right here. So next step, once you define the values, you click OK and you go to the composite layup definition. Please note that this time we don't create a section and we don't define a section assignment. We just create the material for the ply and we define the composite layup. For that you need to select composite layup and then take conventional shell. And here is where you define for each ply the material that you want, the thickness of the ply, and also the direction of the ply. The material is the same, the one that we have created before for every layer, and the thickness is also the same for every layer. The only thing that is different for every layer is the direction, the rotation angle, and you can define it in the same way that we give to you here in the document. Well, once you define all the plies, you click OK. And you have already your part completely defined. Next step, as always, is creating the assembly, importing your instance, which is only the plate, and then we go to the step creation. This time we don't take a general step, we take a linear perturbation and we select buckle. I have already done this. This is the step. And here you can define the number of eigenvalues you want for your analysis. In this particular analysis I will select 2, but you can select 3, 4, 5, as many eigenvalues that you are interested in. Next is the definition of the loads and the boundary conditions. The boundary conditions are those that we give to you here. Quite simple, we constrain the displacements in the x direction for this x. We also constrain the displacements in the y direction for this and this edge, and we constrain all the displacements in the z direction, we constrain the displacements in the z direction for all the edges. The load that we need to create is the reference load for the eigenvalue analysis, and as you should know from the lectures and the videos, we take 1 for simplicity. So We have already our load and our boundary conditions. Next, as we explain you here in the document, is generating a node file output for the eigenvalues. Well, for doing this, you go to the model, you right click, and you select edit keywords. At the end of this file, just before the end step, you need to add these two lines, node file u, and you click OK. So now you have everything prepared for your linear eigenvalue analysis. The only thing left is running the analysis. I have already done it, and I have my results here. This is the first backlink mode, and this is the second one. We only have two because we have requested only two. The eigenvalue, you can see it here in the main screen, but you can see a summary of the backlink modes and the eigenvalues here clicking result step frame. So now we can go directly to the post-backlink analysis. As I told you before, the part and the material are the same than for the linear eigenvalue analysis. So we need to define a new step and slightly different boundary conditions. The step this time, it's a static general, geometrical non-linear analysis, but you also can take the static rigs, which is more recommended for global backlink, but for this exercise I took a static general. So the geometrical nonlinearity option is enabled on, and the incrementation parameters are those that are defined here in the document, just here. So you select OK, and you can go to the boundary condition definition. The boundary condition 1, 2, and 3 are the same than before. The constraint in the X direction for this edge, the constraint in the Y direction for this and this edge, and the constraint in the Z direction for all the edges. The only difference is the boundary condition 4, where I enforced a displacement of 0.5 millimeters in the right edge. This is also explained here. So as I told you, everything is explained in the word, so go very carefully through everything. And we have already everything. Well, not everything. We need to modify one thing. We need to add the imperfection in our model. For that, we go as before to the edit keywords, and this time we need to add another two lines: imperfection, file, buckle job. Well, here I wrote buckle job, but you should write the name of the job that you have given to your linear eigenvalue analysis. So I gave linear perturbation buckling, so my name, as you will see, is linear perturbation buckling. And another important thing is that these lines are going just before the step definition, so this time they are not going at the end of the file, they are going before the step definition. And this number, the meaning of this number, are explained here. Basically, it means I'm going to take the first eigenvalue and I'm going to take a weight factor of 0.1%. You can modify this, you can take the second eigenvalue writing here 2, and you can modify also the weight factor depending on the analysis you want to perform. So everything is ready. We can run our post-backlink analysis. I already have my results here. And we can go to the post-processing. For the post-processing, we want to plot the forces acting on the right edge versus the out-of-plane displacement. So for that, you can take the out-of-plane displacement, for example, of the center node, and you can take the reaction forces of the right edge. So for that, I have already done it, but I will explain you. You go to ODV field output, and you select reaction force in the X direction, because it's the one that you are interested in. And the elements, well, the nodes that you need to select are all these nodes in the right edge. So for that, I created a set with all these nodes for simplicity in this step. But yeah, you also can select these nodes from the viewport, clicking here, edit selection. The other thing you need to export is the displacement in the Z direction. So for that, you select U3 and you take the node in the center of your plate. That I have already created a set for that, so center node. Another important thing is that you have the reaction forces in each node of the right edge. So if you want to have the total reaction force, you need to sum up all these reaction forces in each node. You can do this directly here in Abacus. So for that, you click in operate on XY data, you click continue, and you take the command that is called sum. You select once and then you take all the reaction forces in every node and you click here, add to expression. Then you can save it as total force, for example, and you click OK. So you have already your total reaction force, and also you have the out-of-plane displacement of the center node. So you can directly export this data by clicking Report XY, and you can take total force and the out-of-plane displacement. So you click OK, and you will have in your .rpt file all this data that you have requested. I have this data already here in my Excel, so it is here together with the analytical solution, which is also given to you in the document at the end of the document. So if you plot it, you will be able to see that the results are very, very similar. Well, I hope you have learned how to do the Buckley and post-Buckley analysis. These are the basics, but you will be able to use them for the exercise 3. If you have any question for the exercise, please post it in the discussion board and I will try to help you as always. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.